What is the truth? Does the God accept me after what I have done? Righteous people wonder how to can be safe from the sin. It is enough to only ask the God for forgiveness, how I can convince the God that I am sorry. When somebody commits sins against you, it appears in your mind that you can forgive if that person asks you for forgiveness. If that person with a sorry emotion asks you for forgiveness, I forgive. If you really confess your sin and truly and humbly ask God and Jesus for forgiveness, they forgive. But sometimes you are worried if you are forgiven. In Christ, people used to go to the priest and confess their sin, and the priest asked for forgiveness, and he learned how you should pray for forgiveness. It is important to know how God faces forgiveness. Hebrews 9, part 15. We receive His holy eternal life. We learned about three basic promises: internal activity, friendly relationship, and forgiveness. We study Jesus' holy forgiveness. There is a connection between promise and testimony. I think that the new covenant started when Jesus was born and He introduced the promises and educated us how we can receive them. The testimony started when Jesus became crucified, but Pete Briscoe tells that both started when Jesus became crucified. In many places in Bible, Jesus points on Moses' laws and changed or completed them, like it is sin if you commit adultery. People were happy that they haven't, but Jesus confirmed, if you become attractive to another woman when you see her, you commit adultery, then it is best to draw out your eye and throw away. Another is when somebody beat in your face, show your another side to him. In those time, it made that people be ashamed, but in new time, the person beats and even push you on the ground. Another is when you talk angrily with somebody, then you have committed crime, murder. Jesus talked about the promises. He told that with His blood, the new covenant starts, and new consultant, Holy Spirit, replaces in you and reforms your soul and heart and mind to make you holy, and the holy life I give you. Offering make God to forgive us, and Jesus offered Himself to forgive His followers and His blood. Even in the beginning of creation, when Adam and Eve committed sin and became naked, God gave them animal skin to cover themselves. Eva and Adam didn't know about the death, but to forgive their sin, God offered an animal. Then a blood washed their sin. Why God chose the blood? Why not honey or something else? I think that blood makes the body. God's words remains alive. When you commit sin, you break God's words. To repair that pain or in journey, you must offer blood in old covenant. In new covenant, that blood has been offered by Jesus. Therefore, by confessing sins and truly asking for forgiveness, you are forgiven. Blood is life source. Then Jesus' blood, His life source, washes our sins. He lives in us and we in Him. Our life is His life. Then life healthy and pure and holy. Jesus exchanges our death with His eternal life. He raises us from the death. I have seen few times that sometimes Jesus sacrifices Himself to save His followers from enemies and crimes, their crime. It amazed me, but with shame and sorry feeling. Don't sin to stop that Jesus suffers. Heavenly Father God and Jesus, forgive my sins. I promise to do not do that. Thanks for your loving me and opening my eyes to realize my mistakes. Amen. Respect Jesus' blood and life and live holy. It is God and Jesus' will. If Satan and demons remind your sins, which are forgiven, Holy Spirit brushes from your mind, be thankful for God and Jesus for forgiveness. You must pray that God, I ask for forgiveness with the blood of Jesus, and I promise to don't do it again. Amen. If you ask for forgiveness by offering blood, you become thankful in the rest of your life. Heavenly Father God and beloved Jesus, let the truth be clear in our mind and soul. Let us step in the truth and find our peace and safety. Free us from our mistakes and sin, and let us live under your heaven in your imperium. Thanks God for Jesus to us, and thanks, and I live in this period, new covenant. Please, Jesus, be inside me and heal me and make me as you will, and give me the friendly relationship with the Father God. Let me find your precious forgiveness and receive peace, rest, and freedom. Let me fulfill your purpose of my life, making you proud and happy. In the powerful, strong, and beautiful name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Hebrews 10 part 1. How we should live to come to God's kingdom. We must be complete. During our life, we do a lot of mistakes, like committing sins, don't obey commandments, losing faith. These leads to damage our friendly relationship with the God and Jesus. To understand, we go to the Old Covenant. Think a scale between minus 10 to 0. 0 is forgiveness. Less than 0 is our actions. When we did sin, we fell and got lower score. To be forgiven, we offered yearly. To fall and destroy is easy, but to go back to or become good takes time. Then, when you are holy and are good, don't let sins cause you fall, because you have put time to reach that level of goodness. Friendly relationship is God's will. This destroyed by sins. God wants us to be complete and fit us to His kingdom. Learn everything from the Bible, which is God's words. God's grace is restoring human to His kingdom. In New Covenant, think on a scale between 0 to 10. 0 is forgiveness and 10 is complete perfection. In Old Covenant, when people offered blood of animal for forgiveness, it didn't reach them to 0, only to minus 1. God completes His fully forgiveness by sending us His Son Jesus. When we become baptized, our sins are forgiven and we are reborn. We step into new life. Jesus sent us His Holy Spirit to make us holy by reforming our soul, mind, heart, proper for Jesus, who live in us and we in Him. Jesus offered His life once, which is valid forever. When you ask Jesus for forgiveness, He is kind and forgives. If you commit sins, you fall down to 0. If you continue with your crime, you fall lower under 0, which means that Jesus has left you. Jesus tries to correct you during your life, but when you have preferred be criminal, Jesus rejects you. When you trust Jesus and try to live as Christ, but you fail, don't give up, for Jesus rescued you. You must find your mistakes with help of Jesus to correct yourself. My mistake was that I as Christian lived in Old Covenant. Now, when I found the New Covenant, I can live with Jesus freely, peacefully, and clearly to make Him proud. Amen. True believers are holy. Because I am true believer, Jesus fought for me to find my mistake and correct myself, and reach the score 10, perfection in Jesus. Thanks, Jesus, for our love to each other. Amen. Any unfairly action destroys by a fairly action on Christ. Means that that your sin is forgiven by Jesus' blood on cross. This is the complete plan of God, and that Jesus is sitting at right hand side of God to judge living and dead people. Hebrews 10 part 5. Jesus was sent to this world as human to discover the pain and inhumanities. He started the new covenant, which is to complete the old covenant, offering the animal's blood to be forgiven, be legalized, which is living to the life and God. Jesus educates people how to defeat evils and demons and live safe with God's words. Jesus sacrificed himself over the cross to rescue the world and wash the people's sins, the offer for forgiveness. Each unfairly action is forgiven by a fairly action. I must be holy. Each morning I pray for people be safe from the enemy's evil plans. You must pray to fulfill God's and Jesus' purpose and leave your problems under the cross. You must believe that God and Jesus are in control, and don't be worried, only trust and have faith. Hallelujah. Amen. As long as Jesus was strong in his duty, I am strong too in my faith and belief in Christ. I am holy in Christ. I am not count as holy, but I am holy. As like as Jesus' body has formed by God's words, you must also ask Jesus to form your body. I believe that Jesus resurrected his body to heaven to avoid the grave and destroyed, because his body is holy. In Jesus, we are perfect. In new covenant, our sins are forgiven and forgotten. We live in Jesus' life. You must confess our sins. If you tell that you haven't committed sin, then the Savior doesn't appear. You must confess your sins and ask for forgiveness. When we believe in Jesus, we receive all his messages. Be fair and stay strong and have faith. I love you, God and Jesus, no matter what. I praise you and have huge hope. Your power is beyond any power. Amen. We will talk about three groups of people. One, backturner, a Christian who has left Jesus and accept another religion. The worst is that person talk bad about Christ. Struggling Christian is a Christian who does sins. He confesses and become forgiven, but he commits sin again. He worries that it can be as a regular action. He has heard about another people who are saved and are holy. He worries that maybe he has problem or disabilities. Maybe his trust to Jesus is weak. Three, to deepen, is a person who hasn't enough faith to step into the path. God dips his toe for his trust. All this depends on his contacts with false priests, false churches, and false people. Hebrews 10 part 26. Those people who know about the truth and commit sins and continue with their crimes and doesn't show any respect to the God and Jesus are going to be punished, because there is an offer for them exists. Imagine if you become forgiven only one time at baptized, how it should be. Some people leave their love and become Christian before they die. What is true terrible punishment? Death is physical pain, but our punishment as death is in other words is more painful. When you commit sin with conscience, then you can reach God's aid. Sin is a product of unfaithfulness. To don't trust Jesus is unfair and unclean. If you support demons and evils, you don't find the kingdom of God. Hebrews 7 part 23. Priests in the old covenant tried to find those three promises. They left this world, but Jesus, the highest holy priest, has eternal life. Jesus knows how to rescue us from forever. Trust him. Amen. Hebrews 8 part 12. When Jesus forgives, he forgets too. Hebrews 9 part 12, Jesus offered himself once to wash our sins. He entered to the most holiest place, God's kingdom, by his offering his blood. He rescues us forever by his blood and joins us to the God. Remember that you are forgiven when you accept Jesus in baptized. Hebrews 3 part 16, Moses' followers committed sins in Sahara, even they knew about God's promises. Sin is a product of unfaithfulness. When you deny Jesus, it is sin. When you don't trust Jesus, it is sin. Hebrews 7 part 23, Jesus rescues us forever and eternally because Jesus is alive. Hebrews 10 part 10, we are holy as Christian. The holiness is done only one time. Jesus sitting in the right hand of God and is waiting that demons and evils appears under his chair to destroy them and make his true followers perfect and complete them forever. Amen. John 10, Jesus tells us that we as his sheep listen to his voice. We as his sheep trust him. Jesus gives us eternal life and we don't be destroyed. Hebrews 11 talks about faith. When you believe the God and Jesus, you overcome closer and closer to God's grace and receive the eternal life. Amen.